All right, this is gonna sound clickbaity and you probably know I'm not really into that, but there's a very good chance that you are killing your lithium batteries faster than you really want to be doing it, and you probably don't even know why. So I wanna talk through some of the more popular scenarios that I'm seeing people do with their marine lithium batteries and help you through the best way to take care of them. So you're probably in one of two boats, and tell me if I'm wrong in the comments. One, go to the lake and fish for whatever, 6, 8, 10, 12, 24 hours. Soon as you get the boat in the driveway, in your garage, you plug it in, you charge it up, you want your batteries to be topped off and happy, right? That's great for your lead acid battery or your AGM battery. That is not great for your lithium battery, and we'll talk about why. Scenario two, and maybe you're both of these. You really only need 50 to 60 amp hours, say on your trolling motor batteries. You got 36 volt setup, normal, even a tournament angler is gonna need about 60 amp hours. Well, you got 120 amp hours because you're awesome. And you bought two batteries, you got double the capacity. You can go and troll all over the world. That creates a different scenario because you're not discharging the battery low enough. You're not keeping it within that sweet spot. So let's talk about that sweet spot. Lithium iron phosphate batteries are not happy between 0 and 20% SOC and 80 to 100% SOC. So ideally, you want to operate between that 20 to 80% of the most of the time. That's going to give you less degradation of the cell. It's better, it's happier that way. The cell voltage is within a reasonable range. It's not stressed out at the high end of its voltage range. So when you have too big of batteries on your boat, say you have, you've got 200 amp hours on a 12 volt setup, or you've got 120 amp hours on a 36 volt setup, whatever it is, you have a lot of amp hours, more than you need. When you go out and you only consume 10% of it because you have giant batteries in your boat, you're going from 100 to 90, 100 to 90, 100 to 90 every time you use it. You're never in the sweet spot and you're always stressing those cells, and that accelerates degradation, especially in higher temperatures. So when you keep in mind the capacity of your system, that's okay if you want to have big batteries, but you need to not charge them as much. You need to keep them between that 20 to 80%, something like that, right? Don't charge your boat every time, or your lithium batteries at least, every time you go use it. Let them cycle. Every time I go out fishing, I'm gonna use 15%. So if you come back home and it's at 70%, don't charge them. Let it run down to 55. It's happy doing that. You may be uncomfortable, but the battery is not uncomfortable doing that. It likes to be in that range. So let's talk about storing batteries. You may be looking in your manual and you see something along the lines of, if you're storing the battery, keep it at 50%, charge it every 3 months, and that's storing it. And you may be saying, well, I use my boat every weekend. I'm not storing it. You may feel that way, but as soon as the battery is assembled, the clock starts on it. It is degrading at some rate. If it's fully charged, it's degrading. If it's too hot, it's degrading. If it's sitting too much, it's degrading. If it's used too much, it's degrading. It's just like anything else. It's life, clock starts. So storing the battery is right now. Those batteries are stored. I just used this boat yesterday. The batteries are being stored right now, right? So let's just say you use your boat once every weekend. That means like 85% of the year, the boat's just sitting there, right? It's not doing anything. There's 52 Sundays you go fishing a year, and the remainder of the year, it's sitting there stored. So get that in your head of what storing of a battery is. It is just time with energy not being passed through it. That's storing a battery. So keep that in mind. You want to keep it in that sweet spot that I was talking about earlier. So let's kind of get back into the weeds a little bit, down the rabbit hole of what I'm talking about. There's been a study that was released by the Journal of Electrochemical Society covering the operation window of lithium iron phosphate cells. That's us, LiFePO4. And I'm going to read off some initial thoughts here. So the very first sentence in the conclusion says, cycling near the top of charge, 75 to 100%, is detrimental to LFP cells. Remember what I said earlier, when you come home and you charge it and you just leave it there, or you have giant batteries and it just cycles between 90 and 100, that's detrimental to LFP cells. It also states that time spent cycling at high states of charge is critical to minimize. That's again harping on the guys that are going out, they're using 10%, they're using 15% of their batteries, and they're charging them right back up to the top. You don't want to do that. It's detrimental. It's critical to minimize. Things you don't want to do, right? It also states that the recommendation is for LFP cells for long lifetime applications operate at low states of charge on average, with charging up to 100% only on occasion. Okay, now why would you do that, right? So what it's saying is low SOCs. It really likes to be in that 20 to 80% range. Even lower, right? 30 to 50. That's the low SOC range. They're happier there. And the reason why it's saying occasionally charge it up to 100 is because you got to balance the cells. That you have to do at 100%. So when you lower it down and you're cycling it at low SOCs, eventually those cells are going to start to deviate a little bit in their voltage. You want to bring it up to 100, let them level out, let the BMS do its job, balance the cells, and then go back down there again and use it within those ranges. So how did they get there? So what they did is they tested the cells between 0 and 25%, 0 to 60%, 0 to 80%, 0 to 100, and 75 to 100%. So they broke it out in kind of a design of experiments in different ways to test the batteries. They went through 2,500 hours of cycling and put the same amount of electrons through every cell. So they're just putting the same throughput through each one within those ranges. Again, 0 to 25, 0 to 60, 0 to 80, 0 to 100, and then 75 to 100. They're putting the same amount of energy through them each time. So what you're gonna find is as the capacity of the battery changes over time, that's gonna show you the degradation of the battery, right? So here's a chart that I'll share from a similar video that was done more on the automotive side, but it's showing you that better is to be operating between 0 and 25. You start to get in the windows of that sweet spot that I was talking about, and then red, no bueno, is 75 to 100%. That's kind of re-emphasizing what I was telling you earlier when I was explaining, when you come home and plug in your battery, don't do that. The other thing worth mentioning is the battery testing was done at 104 degrees and 131 degrees F. Now that's super hot, but that's not crazy hot. 104 is a normal summer here in Texas. You know, this battery is stored out here in the driveway all the time, and I can pull up my Bluetooth app, and it's pushing 100 degrees for sure in the middle of summer, because our lows are in the 80s, our highs are in the 105s, and it gets pretty hot. So we've learned that in higher temperatures, the degradation is even faster. What is that? Let's put those pieces together, right? So if you're sitting there, you come home, you fully charge it, it's at 100%, then you leave it in the driveway for 5 days. It's 100 degrees. Your degradation is going to be even further accelerated. You want to mitigate this stuff. You want to not do that. Okay, so let me go ahead and go through it. So what's kind of a summary of what I'm trying to tell you? One is, don't oversize your batteries. If you do, you need to make sure you're operating them in that sweet spot. If you need the capacity because you're going to go all weekend, or you're going to fish a, I don't know, 2-day tournament, and you don't know if you're going to have power, then charge them all the way up. That's fine. You need to do that occasionally. But for the day in and day out, keep them at lower SOCs. They're going to be a lot healthier, they're going to be a lot happier, and they're going to last you a long time. Just remember, your boat is being stored more than it's being used. Unless you're a guide, unless you're literally fishing every day, your boat is being stored more than it's being used. So follow those manufacturer recommendations, put them in context that you are storing your boat and you're not using it all the time. Now that said, it's not the end of the world, and there'll probably be people in the comments saying, well, I've been doing this for 3 years and I've had no problems. Fine. When was the last time you did a capacity test on your batteries? Probably never. And so you don't really know that it's fine until it's not. And where I'm going with that is, it's just take care of your stuff the way it's supposed to be. There's not a ton of information when it comes to marine specific applications. That's why I'm trying to kind of take what has been taught and researched for the automotive world and apply it for you guys. Hopefully you found that valuable. If you did, let me know which one you are. Are you the guy that comes in and plugs it in every day? Are you the guy that has giant batteries, or maybe you're both? Let me know if you learned something. I appreciate you joining us for this one. I know it's a little bit long, a little bit technical, but I hope you found some value in it. Like and subscribe to the channel, and we'll see you next time.